I love stuff that makes me laugh, you know. It's good to be able to laugh at yourself and by yourself. Just, you know, find things that are enjoyable. Let's go to water now. I love a Dr. Pepper and V8. Good deal. Is that a message in group chat? I think it was. This is my sense of humor. Nice, Chimney. Dude, is it really? That's awesome. In that case, I've got another story for you, dude. Because it is, like, right up that alley and makes about as much sense as that. I was like, alright, I won't hit them with two nonsense stories in a row. I'll give it some time. The stack of worms! But alright, I'm going to tell you the story of the Chows. This is a good one. Alright. And before I do, anybody in stream know the story of the Chows? I've told it, I think, a couple times long ago. I just want to see who knows. I know Sean Offwhite knew, but he's not here anymore. He's going to actually try it in real life. Yeah, if you like that, you're going to love this one. Ready, Mark. Out. Vendor. And we're at, what are we at? 45k, nice. Sweet. Yeah, dude, I just vendor the worms, like, I don't use them. I don't use them at all. Cool, we're done. Nice. Yes, I love stories, it's great. High five! Also, I think you're right. Yeah, for sure, dude. What do you win? You do win a high five. What's up, man? There you go. Yeah, that was pretty good. Well, that was funny. I mean, it's an okay joke, at least, since we're all trying to make it up that day. My wife hates this humor, but I love it. Does she really? Oh no, man. That's terrible. Hope you know I'm gonna make you retell these stories in like a month. You do seem to want me to keep telling these stories. Well, the next time I'm grinding, entertain me. Honestly, I don't have to retell the stories. I can just tell you more stories. And we got Blue Brian. Welcome to the stream. Alright guys, the Chow story. This is good. This is good. Alright, so this was actually just last month. I was leading another sales team. It was Corrosion and one other guy. And we basically had to hit three different parts of the country over the course of 3 weeks or so. So we went around Chicago, went to Indiana, went down to Maryland, places like that. It's around the Midwest. I was like, all right, this is my sales team. We have a lot of work to do. It's another holidays, right? Because it's the end of last year. It's a fun run. Exactly. And I was like, all right, what is kind of interesting? Now, I kind of built this game, it wasn't a joke, it was a game, on the spot. We went out to Cracker Barrel, and somehow somebody was getting sauce named Chow, or called Chow Sauce. I was just having fun, and I was like, Chow Sauce? What is that, from a Chow Chow dog? What is that? That's crazy. So, you know, it is not from a Chow Chow dog, by the way. But anyway, we started just talking about Chows, and I thought Chow's actual combination of words, they were pretty funny. So after this lunch, I was like, you know, Chow Chow. I think I'm just gonna say this to the last person that I see in Cracker Barrel. And just let it go. So I ended up paying for the meal and we bought some random stuff. And at the end of Cracker Barrel, I was like, Chow Chow Chow. And it was very like what? It was very. It didn't seem like he had a lot of confidence anyway, so it almost looked like he took it as an insult, which obviously it should not have been taken that way. But he was kind of like, alright. And I realized it sounded as if I said, I called him a chow chow, like a dog, and I was saying goodbye to him. So it was almost like, chow, chow chow. And I didn't want to be snarky about this, but I was thinking, I was like, this is kind of funny. So I remember I had my sales team together, I was like, guys, I've come up with a game for us. Because we had weeks on the road together, and we had to, like, do something. So I was like, here's how this game's gonna work. I'll start it, then it'll go to you, Corrosion, and then it'll go to you, Robert was the other guy. And I was like, what we're gonna do, whenever we see somebody who works in retail, like somebody in a professional setting, the last thing we'll say to them is chow. Just one chow. I'll start it. We'll do whatever. You gotta make eye contact, and you just gotta be like, chow! And then you just go, you walk away, and you're done. Well, the way the game goes is, after I finish my chow, Corrosion had to do that and finish with his chow. So it was pretty easy, you know, I would just go up and said chow to somebody, and then we went to the third guy, Robert, who would say chow. And then when it got back to me, I had to add a chow to it. So I had to say, at the end of something that I was doing, I'd have to be like, all right, chow, chow, and then continue on. And like, we did this in Burger King's, we went to Cabela's, we went to rest stops, and like all different places we went over the course of a week. And like, when I finished my two chows, Corrosion had to do his two chows, and then Robert had to do his two chows, and they got to three. And I was like, all right, I did this once the first time, so it shouldn't be too bad. Like, you gotta make eye contact the whole time, this is great. Just like, ended with, you know, chow, chow, chow. And I was fine, because I already practiced, I was good. Corrosion pulled his off also. But Robert was starting to get a little bit nervous about doing this. He's like, I don't want to say chow to somebody three times. And, you know, he's a salesman, so he was able to overcome it and everything. But the way he dealt with it, he was like, I'll just say it like I'm saying goodbye, and I'll say it really slowly. So what he did, I think it was way worse than what I did it. He would literally like look at them and be like, chow, chow, chow. And then he'd leave. He'd like give them three goodbyes like that. And he finished his three. So then it was my turn. I had my four chows. I was like, all right, four chows. This is gonna be really good. And we could only do it if it was in front of the other two people. So like we all got to enjoy the experience and see how we all did it. Like, this lasted over the course of a week, basically. I was like, oh, let me make up something fun to do with my sales team, you know, let me have some fun with this. And it was, I think, at Cabela's where I finished it. And it's very casual, like, okay, do you know if you have any of this in black? No? Alright, well, that's fine. Thanks a lot, I appreciate your help. Oh yeah, no problem. Is there anything else I can help you with? No, I should be alright. Chow, 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 chow. Walked away. Like, okay, chow. Like they gave us a chow, you know? It was like, it was just crazy, it was hilarious to us. We had to keep our other two guys, whoever wasn't chowing at the time, like, to stop from freaking out laughing. It was wonderful. And we got up to five chows. So I finished my five chows, and they couldn't do five chows, unfortunately. They ended up stopping at four. But we also parted ways, too, at the end of, you know, our tour and everything. But that's my story, guys, about the chows. I recommend that you take it and you see how many chows that you can get up to. Start with one chow, go to two chows, go to three chows. And I was excited. I was like, I'm going to end with just chows, like 17 chows. I'm going to order something, and then after I order, it'll be like, chow, 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 chow. And then just nothing. Like, you can't say anything after the chows because you can't explain it at all. No, you just have to hit them with the chows and that's it. You're done. So I was hoping, like, we're going to get 20 chows going, and it would be nuts. We stopped at 5, but I want you guys to, like, take it. Take it and run with it. You guys are the stream, the internet. Just go. Just see what you can do. And then come back and tell me about it. I want to hear the chow stories, guys. Oh, man. Yeah, Jeremy, absolutely. And I mean, I know you make videos all the time. You can use that as, like, your own creation or whatever and, like, offer that up as a challenge and see what people do with it. I've said it, I think, 3 times on the stream. I'm just curious to see what we could... I just want to hear the stories, you know, because it was so fun to do, man. It was so great. Nothing like having an inside joke with, you know, you and your buddies, and you're just, like, not doing anything harmful to people, but it's, like, it's that awkwardness and, like, what is happening? I'm out of my comfort zone, but it's fun.